good, ladies and gents? Welcome to the MKO Pugilism Boxing Channel, where we talk all things box. Remember to like, subscribe, hit the bell notification, put it on all so you get notified straight away as soon as we drop any new content on the channel. So without further ado, let's get into this one. So recently, just 2 days ago now, we had the card that was supposed to be headlined by Dillian White, O2 Arena. You know, Chantel Cameron versus Mary McGee, that took the main event slot. And prior to that, we had this fight between Alan Babich, the Savage, or Alan the Savage Babich, who took on his sort of biggest test on paper against Eric Molina. Molina is a bit of a sort of gatekeeper. He's a guy that can punch quite hard. He managed to sort of wobble Deontay Wilder, give Deontay Wilder a scare a few years ago, but obviously Wilder's class and his power told, and you know, so he's a guy with a bit of pedigree, definitely can punch, got a few skills. So for someone like Alan Babich, who's a prospect, you know, is early 30s, but he's only had I think that was his 8th fight, so he's a guy that is still on his way up. He's not quite at the upper echelon in boxing yet. So he meant business from round one in his fight, went straight after Eric Molina, and within the first, I think it would have been about what, the first, I want to say between the first 10 seconds or something crazy like that, comes out, you know, bit of head movement and just charges after Molina, you know, moves left, gives him a nice arcing overhand right, and puts Molina down, and it looked like quite a heavy knockdown. Molina looked shocked, he looked surprised, he looked like he weren't ready for that. And you could see all the way through the contest, it didn't last very long at all, just a round and a half, I think. And all through the contest, it was just purely Babich just marching forward. He was a little bit more careful in this fight than he normally is. He did sort of pause at certain times when he was coming forward, but literally this was one of them fights where he was just running through Eric Molina. You know, Molina got bundled to the floor a few times just based on the sheer pressure, the grit, the determination of Alan Babich, you know what I mean? So he, you know, you could tell in Molina's eyes, he certainly didn't want to be there. After that first knockdown, you know, he suffered a few more, and a lot of the time, you know, he was just being sort of bundled to the canvas just because of the sheer pressure and just the that strength of Alan Babich. And it was just a case of Babich is just one of them guys where, okay, you can be bigger than him, you can be stronger than him or whatever, but he you know, at a certain level, that's not going to be enough. And with a guy like Molina, his sheer size and strength just wasn't nowhere near enough. He just didn't have the desire for this fight. And as much as it was the punches of Alan Babich that put him away, it was also just the strength and that grit that he has, that he's just so determined to just keep coming forward. And, you know, first round, Molina got off the hook a little bit, got lucky to survive the first round because Babich didn't really follow up too effectively. But second round, you know, Babich just again just steamed into him, the head down, and just winging away with these wide shots that he can only get away with, I think, at this sort of level. He can't get away with these shots at a high level, as you know, even British, European level can't get away with them shots. But against a Molina who, you know, as a fight wore on in that second round, had no real desire. You know, he got hit with a hard shot. I think it was like a right hand. And, you know, he took it. And then when the end came when it was, he sort of took this shot. And then there was a few seconds, there was a bit of wrestling between the two, and he just sort of fell on the floor. And, you know, that was what caused the end of the fight. It was a kind of weird ending where it was almost like what ended the fight, at least in my view of watching it, wasn't even a punch. It was just like it was just a bit of, you know, he did get hit with a shot, but it was like, let's say 10-15 seconds later, he then goes on the floor, but it is based on the sort of wrestling and whatever they were doing, you know, based on the tussling that you do sometimes. So Azam, I think Hatman said in his blog that, look, you know, he should have been just told to get up by the referee, because what put Molina down wasn't even a punch. It was just, they were doing their little wrestling and struggling and tussling, and he goes on the floor, and then that was it. That's the end of the fight in round two. I think it was definitely one of them where it was a combination of the determination, you know, the just relentless pressure of Alan Babich to really want him this fight. I wouldn't even say it was necessarily punching power, but it's one of these guys where Molina doesn't, you know, he doesn't want to smoke. He doesn't really want to, you know, he just doesn't have any desire to sort of fight. It's like once he gets hit, once he gets caught, he's ready to just, you know, find that spot on the canvas and just, you know, just stop fighting right there. He's ready. He's been paid. It's over for him. And, you know, that's what it is. And yeah, this was one of them where, yes, on paper, good test, good challenge for Babich. But the reality was he did not have any desire to really continue or even try to compete in this match. You know, once he got hit, once he felt a bit of a punch, it was over. So yeah, that's my thoughts on it. Good win on paper for Alan Babich. And until next time, MKO Pugilism, over and out.